Welcome to Knights of Roleplay, an adventuring podcast. This is an actual play Dungeons & Dragons podcast. Royalty-free music provided by Kevin MacLeod, Michael Gelfi Studios, Plate Mill Games, and Tabletop Audio. And now, to adventure. Hello, listeners. Thank you for joining us for this episode of Knights of Roleplay. I'm DM Chris, and when this episode airs, my paranormal podcast will have episodes 1, 2, 3, and 4 already released. That's called Real Paranormal Stories Podcast. Please check it out and share it with anybody that you think likes ghost stories read by me. And then I'll turn it over to John for more Tomb of Annihilation.
Yeah, ghost stories.
Sounds creepy.
Stuff.
Yeah. If this keeps up, we'll all be ghosts.
Working on it.
Okay. Ghost stories. Fairly. A la Dirkris.
All right, well, welcome back, intrepid dungeon delvers. When we last left our group, you had investigated the wet hallway and managed to work your way through the water curtain. Didn't take you too much. Started to investigate another tomb, decided, maybe don't really want to. Turned around and so instead decided to just start crawling through a whole bunch of little crawlways. The result of which is that you found another eye in a spinny capture trap, but the eye cost you poor gears. You had to leave him behind. You've exited back out into the wet, at the north end of the wet hallway, where you have stopped to collect your thoughts. A quick retcon. In the windy hallway, Winds of Pandemonium, I told you that you collected one jewel from the statue. He actually had two, so Dirkus was able to grab both of them, one in each hand.
I don't know what you're talking about.
As they ran by.
So we actually have all the eyes.
So you're currently holding 8 eyes.
But for at least 6.
There's 2.
We think we have 6, but really 8.
Yeah. There's 2 in the door already.
The only 2 we don't know about are the ones that you grabbed.
That she took from her ghost body.
Yes, yeah. I'm just being a pain in the ass.
As Sarah is wont to do. Love you.
So you think you have 5, but really 8.
6. Yeah.
You didn't see me grab the second one from the hand. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, she's only fessing up to one, not both. That's even more interesting. But I don't understand.
But
there
she's
was two things
give me
in
my
two
genie
hands.
Back,
so there was only one when I got there. It must have blown away.
The gin is back to sulking in its bottle, and everybody is tired after a very long day of crawling around in a very exhausting tomb. You are now, you have expended enough time that you are now able to get the benefits of a long rest.
You're eligible.
Okay. So where do we want to go?
The 10x10 room that was before the hallway with the curtain of water seems like a good place.
So I'm okay with taking a rest.
Go,
I mean,
can all four, so can all five of us fit in a 10x10 room?
You do have to go back through the water curtain, but
we can use the tridents. We don't have to go through the spinning hallway. I mean, before we do this, we're standing right by a source of water. Do you want me to try to borrow his bowl if he'll let me? I'll give it back, I promise, and summon an elemental and tell it to crawl down that hallway. Yeah, I mean, it's water. It's a larger creature, but I believe it would be able to squeeze. It might get you gears back, but if we're going to rest and you would rebuild anyway, then I mean, it's up to you. He is your pet.
Yeah, that sounds good.
John is trying to break my heart out of my chest. Put it on the table and stab it with a knife.
Stupid meta question. Does the old construct have to die for you to be able to build a new one?
Okay. Once he creates another one,
the other one ceases to exist. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I mean, that's probably the less risky path. The water elemental, if I get hurt and lose concentration, yeah. we're in trouble because that thing's yeah. going to go rogue and come after us for an hour. So,
yeah, you summon a water elemental, then, you know, these reliefs are going to come alive and attack you and try to damage you just so you can lose control of the water elemental. You know I'm going to do that.
He can't necessarily do that.
No, I'm not going to do that.
Derbys will fight tooth and nail to the death to make sure that pretty lady does not get hurt.
Aw. Even though she doesn't trust her.
Correct.
But then she's admitted she has issues with trust and crazy factor with other women, so...
Cut her act.
Even before the god.
Thorbris is very complicated, Kobold.
I love her. She's great.
Alright, so where are you going?
So the 10 by 10 room?
Yeah, well,
so
you use the tridents to come through and get okay, to the 10 by yep. 10 room.
There are tridents on this side. You know yep. the trick, so getting through the curtain of water. The curtain of water.
The curtain of water.
Curtains for ya, I tell ya. is not a problem.
Okay.
At south end, of course, you have the crawlway on your left and the hallway on your right. DM Fiat says that your computer's GPS lets you know that you can just get in through that crawlway.
Okay. Cool.
Yay, so long yep. rest.
So yep. So you get down to the crawlway and you are all just able to squeeze into this 10 by 10 room.
This is the dusty room that we checked three times over and only had a perception of like two between two characters.
Do you now wish to attempt a long rest?
Yes.
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 Okay.
For the listeners, John pointed at me when he said GPS.
Starting factors. Does anybody who would be encumbered by taking their armor off care to use a potion of watchful rest to get that rest having to sleep?
Paladin!
Yes, I know who she's talking about. Thank you very much.
Because I have them.
Sure.
As it turns out, Shatterkai seem to like to carry those.
Yes, thank you. I will take it.
So she gives you one of her three. Does anybody else want to use one of these so you can take the rest without sleeping, depending on...
Chris very much wants to sleep and dream of sexy kobold girlfriend.
Okay. I mean...
Hopefully.
I don't know if anybody... I've heard
is
some stories about dreams. Are there bad dreams that can happen when you try to rest here? I
don't know.
Yeah, I mean... Mm.
I simply enter sentry mode. I'll be aware.
I mean, and that's... I trance, so I can't speak to it either. That's why I wanted to ask if there was a risk for you guys that your sleep would not be restful. I offer it as a solution.
Well, I will accept it.
It's good for my...
Kate's talking about levels of exhaustion.
Do I have to put that in my inventory to use it or something?
I mean, no. If you're going to use that, I don't think John's going to make you put it in your inventory only to take it.
Sarah's going
to
risk it. Okay. Sarah's going to risk it. Darkris live on the edge.
Okay.
I forget, do you already have one level?
What?
I thought we had a couple people who took levels of exhaustion after the last rest.
A couple of
people. And I was playing as Tavriel. That character died. So Kalana doesn't know any of it. Kalana doesn't know any about it. Sorry. I'm graceful.
Keep smash. Oh, so what you're telling us is you're medicating. Because one of your previous characters had issues with resting.
Well, no. Tavriel doesn't have issues. Elves don't have issues. All my characters are Shatterkai. They will never have a problem.
So you're medicating.
Yeah, that's...
Yes.
Medicaid is putting the idea out there.
Yes. Dirkris is so unobservant to what's happening to other people, she would have never recognized that Tavriel did not sleep well the last time.
Oh, Tavriel was fine.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Anywho.
Anyway.
So.
I'm going to risk it.
Okay, so you're going to risk it. You're using a potion of rest thing. What does that do again?
When you drink this potion, you gain the following benefits for the next 8 hours. Magic can't put you to sleep, and you can remain awake during a long rest and still get its benefits.
Okay. Okay, so you're chugging a potion. You're drinking your coffee. And you're going to standby. Everybody else is going.
I'm going to trance for four hours in whatever rotation works best for other people keeping hour. People only need to sleep for 6 hours out of the eight. So we should do 2 hour watches for those who can't. I mean, I can do 4 hours of watch when I'm not trancing so that we
also
have eyes on the situation. You can take watch the whole time. Yeah. Okay, so yeah. All right. I'll just do my trance right away, and then...
Okay.
How long does it take to attune to something?
1 hour. You can do that during this long rest if you wish to attune to something. You can also, if you have anything that needs to be identified.
We also have to see if we can...
I vaguely recall that Hergoth had found something that helped with casters, like with spells or something like that. Did you find that on him?
It was an ion stone, I think.
Pearl of Power. It was the dragon egg, aka the Pearl of Power. She already touched and got the god, so you wouldn't be giving up a god by giving that to anybody, but if you're not going to use it, would your character share it with someone else who's a caster so they can attune with it?
It's something that Hergoth had.
That you picked up. It was an egg-shaped thing.
You gave me a list of what I picked up.
I didn't?
No.
Someone was supposed to give that to her. I thought, I don't know if it was you.
Well, she doesn't have something.
I don't know.
It's probably my fault.
I don't know.
Now there's ogres.
Suffice to say, yeah, amongst the list of things was an egg-shaped item that when you picked up is when you picked up nyang nyang.
Yeah, that didn't say anything about that in my description of nyang nyang.
Right, but the amulet you're wearing was the artifact that carried Papa Zodal.
Right.
So the pearl, the egg has benefits just like the amulet has benefits. The egg functions
right,
as
a pearl.
Right,
but none of the benefits that, I don't know what benefits you're talking about.
It's a pearl of power.
That's pretty much it. Yeah. I mean,
the only benefits I remember were walking on the ceiling. And stuff.
We're not talking about the benefits of the god. We're talking about the item itself.
Well, I didn't receive anything that told me about item's benefits.
It's all
right. I'm saying that that's where I dropped the ball.
Okay.
So, and I'm trying to look it up now. Where was that? That was in.
And my character doesn't want to give you anything, so I don't know why we're even having this discussion.
I was asking because it's an item that would benefit a caster, and I don't know if your character would want to bolster the casters in her party or if
she doesn't even know what it is
because she wants the stuff.
It is a petrified egg that functions as a pearl of power, and a pearl of power is an item that allows you to regain expended spell slots.
You're putting me in a position.
Not
you, her. Because I look like a jerk face if I don't.
If that's her character and she hoards treasure right now even more than she normally would, I'm fine with it. Kalana is asking you and giving you an opportunity to bald-faced lie to lie to her again about what you took off her god's body. Play your character. I love you no matter what. You know it. It's fine.
I don't know why you keep asking me questions about what I took off that stupid red-faced goblin. I'm sorry. He wasn't a goblin.
He was a tiefling.
I do not mean to insult you, my friend. That stupid red-faced thing's body, I did not find anything. He was wet and gross and dead.
Sergius doesn't like my characters.
It's just because I know that I can make fun of you. And we still hug and I laugh about it later.
I love it.
I suppose I'm curious about how you lost Papa, because we heard you screaming about losing Papa, but I mean, I don't know how this tomb works.
And then Papa just jumped out of me. I don't know why my Papa left. Why did your Papa leave?
Insight check. Insight check. You're going to make her roll deception to my insight again there?
It sounds like a situation where yes, that
all
would
right.
be necessary.
Dice, are you going to behave more this week? Let's find out.
My dice have been terrible all week, so let's see. All right. 17. Okay. That's with a negative 2.
18.
Ooh. She seems like she might be hiding something to you, but that really could be anything.
Okay.
As far as you know.
I mean, Kalana is basically, she's 250 years old. She's going to do the, you know, kind of raise an eyebrow, but this is her friend, this is her ally. She doesn't want him getting into a bunch of drama right now, so she's just going to let it slide.
I'm curious to know how you're going to handle when you get to the door. So, but...
I am too.
It will be interesting for everyone.
All right. So, anyway,
they fell to the floor.
So, anyway, let's get ahead of ourselves. So you're huddled in this little 10x10 room. It's a little cramped, a little stuffy. Yeah. A lot of hot bodies.
Yeah, they are.
And not much airflow through these tiny little vents. But a couple hours goes by, and nothing happens. A couple more hours goes by,
right.
And still nothing happens.
And one of those hours I've attuned to the bracers.
Okay. Go ahead and put it... mark that down.
And now she's up in her trance. So I say, has someone looked to see if that weapon that they found looked magical? The Yikwa? Cough, cough, strength fighters. You might want to look at that. Cough, cough.
Who has it?
The Yikwa? I think you took the stuff off the skeleton. You were the first person. Mm-hmm. No.
That was
the person who inspected it. AA.
That
you found a weapon of some kind on the skeleton, didn't you?
You found...
Skeleton had an eyeball and a weapon?
It had a
Yikwa. It had a couple of different things. I can get you the list again.
John kind of went through that real quick at the end of last adventure.
You keep saying you're giving us lists of things. I never see a list.
Oh, you guys are supposed to be writing this down, too.
We got a Yikwa.
You never say it in...
Well-crafted Yikwa, which is a long staff with a 18-inch blade on it. We got a Dungeoneer pack. We got something worth 8 gold points, or just 8. We got... an ivory back scratcher worth 25 gold, a Bahamut medallion worth 25 gold, and a red crystal eyeball.
See?
I will take the Bahamut medallion. It's part dragon.
But, I mean, this doesn't look like a weapon I could use effectively, but if one of you wants to spend some time, if you're done with your part of rest, or...
It's just a regular Yikwa.
Well, you haven't really checked it out yet.
You would have to identify and possibly attune if it ends up being magical.
I mean, you can usually tell if something is magical without identifying it, and yes, it does seem to be magical.
I mean, for you, your sword and board?
So I could use another hour to... Wait, do we have a...
This is the longest long rest I've ever had.
We haven't even... We're only halfway through it.
I know.
I'm just trying to make sure we think of all the magical attunement things while we're...
Yeah, you don't have to attune to it. It is a standard, it is a simple plus one.
Okay.
So.
So I don't know if that's any better than your mace. I guess it's probably not, because the mace lets you do that terror effect.
Mm-hmm. It might be better.
And as much as I would like to take it, because I have no magic weapons, my strength is my dump stat, so I'm not going to fight well with that thing.
Is it a two-handed weapon?
I mean...
No, it's a...
It's like a broken spear.
I thought
almost.
You could use it.
I mean, it
has a thrown range, which is interesting. It's a 1d8 piercing...
With a thrown property.
With a thrown property, and I want to say, doesn't it have range also?
No.
I'm going to go on a limb, Greg, and say it's really not better than whatever you're using to fight with right now.
It's probably not better than your mace. Yeah,
okay.
However, having a magical weapon would be nice. In case.
I mean, I want you an AA sword.
I have a rapier, so.
You have a magic one?
He's been shooting things. You've got a magical shooting.
I've never used my melee weapon.
So
why don't you keep it in case you need a melee weapon? It's fine. I will continue to be neat shield.
Okay. All right. Fine.
You get magic weapons when you're raging.
Two more hours goes by.
Okay.
Nothing happens.
feel like he's just doing that to mess with us.
The last 2 hours goes by.
Johnny.
Still nothing happens.
Nothing.
You all successfully managed to get a long rest.
Thank you.
So, go
for
ahead
the love of Kozra.
Plus the Yik was a strength weapon.
Oh, that would definitely work for me.
Yeah, that's
what it worked for me. Another strong.
Yeah, but you can't use the Yikwa to release waves of terror or anything if it has no additional perks. Then.
Actually, it's a magical weapon, so I can use my intelligence.
Well, there you go.
I'm going to swap my rapier out for my Yikwa.
For Yikwa?
Yeah.
Yikwa. What? Yik what?
I couldn't figure out how to spell it, so I didn't see it.
That was weird. Stupid.
I suddenly feel very angry.
At the end of our long rest,
Sarah has her rages back that she hasn't had for like half a day.
After you've managed, after you reassemble,
is this Gears 2.0?
Gears.
Gearser.
1.1.
Geezer.
Gearsier.
It goes.
I rebuilt it bigger, better. Well, at least exactly the same as he was.
Yeah, it's 1.1. 2.0 is when you get the improved guardian.
I don't want to talk about it.
Is it the keymaster?
It is not the gatekeeper.
All right. So.
Okay. So, you all managed to wake up from your long rest, healthy and refreshed. Those of you who were down one level of exhaustion have that cleared now. If any of you were still alive. Otherwise,
it's so nice to have spells again.
I know.
Should we head to the thing with the eyeballs in it?
We didn't even do the thing yet.
I mean,
sorry.
We could go place the six eyeballs that we have. I have one idea for the tomb with the hieroglyphs, but it would require sending people up to that top entrance to pop down. I don't know if we want to try that right now or just wait. I'm wondering if the plaque talking about the vulture is the first step might imply that the vulture is the only step. Like maybe we just need someone to stand on that first tile where we saw Hergoth stand and not get hurt. We saw the dwarf stand before he walked off of it and got killed. And if one person stands on that tile, maybe the sarcophagus would unlock. I don't think we tried that the last time we were in that room. But we would need the rest of the party to go up to the other floor and come down through the hole in the top. Am I making sense?
It seems like an interesting observation.
I mean, we could.
I mean, it's up to you guys. I mean, we don't have all. We're still short two eyeballs. We could go place the other six.
PH98 knows nothing about that particular room, so
I know.
I say that we go unload these eyeballs into that door.
Okay. I mean, we're short too, but I'm okay with it. We can go see how the mirror changes, if it changes more.
Yeah, yeah.
It was a little concerning what it did the last time.
I put some in the door.
You've placed two in the door thus far.
We started looking more
and we have
pale.
Six more. Really? Eight.
Something in my throat.
I thank you for at least trying to roleplay that. Actually, screw it. You tried to roleplay it. I'll allow it. Take inspiration.
Oh, I will give inspiration to my hobby this time. If you don't have it already. So that I can take the new one.
No, my character's too new.
There we go.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Because you already had it, right?
No.
No?
I used mine.
Oh.
I have it still. I have not used
mine. I've given it to your character before, so I'm trying to share.
I
what's your inspiration?
I'm pretty sure I actually gave you inspiration.
Oh, did
from
you
mine.
Give me? Oh,
but it's
now
good.
I feel
it's
bad.
Fine.
It's fine. I'm not
totally
hurt or anything.
I'm totally fine with that.
Totally fine with it.
No. I wasn't saying it because I'm hurt.
I know.
She wouldn't be giving me inspiration at this point. She's pretty pissed at me because I'm lying to her a lot. Which is nothing
she
like me in real
you.
Life, so it's really fun for me. I don't get to do this in real life because I would feel too guilty.
Okay, where to? You wake up. You're still all cramped at a 10 by 10. And so you're going to attempt to make your way over to the doorway.
The room with the
wiz. If we're going to go back to the doorway, we've got to go back to that creepy statue room.
Yeah. I mean, that seems to be the only way, unless we go through the crawlway back to the... Well, no, as far as we know, that's the only way to get to the room with the eyeballs.
Unless you really want to go back to the laundry room.
I really don't want to go back to the laundry room.
No, I don't want to go back to the laundry room.
But the laundry room is such clean fun.
No, the laundry room is terrible.
Okay, then you proceed through the opposite crawlway that you came in and find yourself standing next to a creepy statue with... closed hands and a bunch of platforms that get you over to the other side.
As we're crawling through the crawlway, I'm going to try to position myself behind Kalana. Kalana?
You were following me through anyway. Yeah, Kalana.
Kalana?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And I want to do a sleight of hand check.
To do what?
Really?
To plant the eyeballs on her.
Oh my God.
All right, go ahead.
Is that versus my passive, or
if since you're not expecting it, yeah, it'll be versus your passive.
Okay.
It would be kind of hard to explain.
You miss and put it in her butt.
Oh!
Wah, wah.
10.
My passive is 17.
Yeah, I know.
You feel a little tug on your satchel, or whatever it is you carry things in.
Okay, I turn around, and what has happened? Like, did the eyeballs tumble on the floor? Like, I need more.
You see Dirkus's hand in your backpack, in your satchel.
Oh, sorry. I was aiming for your butt.
I'm flattered.
But
I reach into the satchel. What do I find there?
You did not successfully plant the crystals, so the contents seem to be correct.
Okay.
Based on what you're feeling.
Eyebrows are raised further, but she chooses to let it slide.
You're letting a lot slide here. Okay.
What's the alternative here?
She prohibited PvP.
Yeah, I know.
No. Alana loves her party members and maybe has a soft crush on this other party member. And
I was aiming for her butt. I'm
your home wrecker.
I mean, it's hard to get the butt when you're crawling.
I was trying to goose her.
And all you can see when you're crawling is someone's butt.
Exactly.
She also understands that she's under the influence of the god that she saw make pretty drastic changes in her goth just in the short time that
you don't know this. You don't know this.
She suspects.
You suspect
this. She suspects.
You don't know this.
Your latest deception check was poop.
It wasn't poop. It was only one below yours.
That's not poop.
That's not poop. That's actually pretty decent.
That's only a mild suspicion at that.
That's only you going.
She suspects.
I don't know.
She suspects, and now someone groping into her pack is more suspicious, but she's letting it slide.
Don't be suspicious. Okay. Don't be suspicious.
Well,
don't be suspicious. Don't be suspicious.
She is going to be more watchful of her now, though, John. Okay. So, she's going to be on the lookout to see if she attempts something like that again.
Anyway, for the strong characters, I'm not going to bother with anything. How are you getting the weak characters across this time?
Can we throw them?
Same thing. Second verse, same as the first.
Oh, so you're just going to carry them along the wall?
Yeah.
Okay, then we'll just move on past that.
I will
that
wear
then.
Them like a backpack.
The old Yoda.
I could have thrown some people. But.
In the meantime, I'd like to also make a sleight of hand check to try to plant the eyeballs on the goblin.
Since you're carrying him.
Wow. Go ahead, get up on my back.
Since you're carrying him, I'll let you make that check with advantage.
Like slip it in his sock. Dirty 20.
What's your passive, AA?
15.
Okay. You slip two crystal eyeballs into his backpack.
When she's carrying Kalana across, Kalana's going to make a game of this. She's going to try to do sleight of hand to touch the amulet.
Are you groping my chest?
You just tried to grope my butt. I don't know.
There's a good thing, touchy feeling now.
That's actually an interesting technical question. Can you activate something that somebody else is wearing?
It's not in the chain, it's in the amulet, right?
Or is it in the whole thing?
It's a conflict between general D&D rules. If somebody's wearing something, it generally is kind of...
still in their
you
possession.
You can't really activate it.
Can't really activate it.
Yeah, generally speaking.
Generally speaking, when they're wearing it.
You could sleight of hand to try to accidentally yank it off my neck.
That's a possibility to try to remove
it. I mean, is it around your neck when you tucked it in your shirt, or did you fully unhook it so you could, like, fully hide it in your bra?
No, it's still around my neck.
Yeah, and you're still attuned to it.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that she attuned.
Pretty sure I attuned to it. Okay.
Yeah, it does require attunement, and you're getting its benefits, so.
Okay.
What was its benefits?
The constitution, if I remember right. It's the amulet of health.
So put your constitution at 19?
Would Kalana...
I never added that.
No?
No.
Sure?
Yes, because it wasn't on the god sheet.
Well, no, their items are never on the god sheets.
Right, so I never added that to my...
Or is that the one that gives you advantage when you're rolling saving throws or something? I don't know.
No, that was the god's advantage.
No, let's see, that was for...
magic items.
Papazol's Boom. Yeah, it functions as an amulet of health, which requires attunement and sets your constitution score to 19.
Yeah, I never attuned to it then.
That's right.
Okay.
Well, you just had an opportunity to do so, so we can say that you did or didn't. I'll allow you to make that call. Just have an amulet of health in your inventory and just hit the attune button. It should.
Yeah, I have it in my inventory. I never attuned to it.
Probably never had the chance to.
That's true because we haven't really been taking.
Since our last, we just did.
I'll attune to it.
Heard the things. Would my character know enough about magic items to even think that, like if she had to get it fully off her person to see if she could activate it, would she think that that would work without the attunement? I mean, she's fairly studious and somewhat magically.
I'm going to have to just kind of squelch that at this point. Because and just move past it.
Okay.
If it, yeah, she's got it attuned, you're not a hostile, so...
Okay.
No, you can't take it off her.
Okay. Fair enough.
I mean, you can try to grab it and see if anything happens, but, you know...
No.
You're just going to make her more excited about the fact that you're pretty.
I guess I'll pass. If she has that knowledge, she probably wouldn't. Yeah. I mean, the only reason she would try to do it would be to try to get the god with the assumption that having more gods benefits the party. So she didn't think that.
It's not a bad assumption, but in this particular case, because she's wearing it and because she's attuned to it, and or because she's attuned to it, it's probably not going to work unless she lets go of it.
Okay.
Should that then affect my armor class?
Constitution, no.
Affects your hit points.
Oh, it affects my hit points.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Did it automatically update you in D&D Beyond?
It did. Added the numbers to my constitution.
Nice.
I don't think it updated my hit points, though.
That's what I was wondering, yeah.
Yeah. It's fine. Just keep going.
Okay.
She'll sort it.
All right. So you get it. So you climb across the big pit. You head up the stairs. You find yourself in the room with the pit that had the golem in it, with the hallway at the far end, which takes a right turn. And takes you to a big mirror with two little shiny
eyeballs
attached to little spaces around the mirror.
Okay.
Your reflection in the mirror looks a little pallid.
A little paladin?
I guess let's place. I mean, I sure hope there isn't a specific order we have to place these. These two, we couldn't remove them once we placed them, right?
Right. Well, let's get to it.
Let's push
get those six
ones.
In there.
Yeah.
I have the one that I have.
All right. You stick the little crystal eye into one of the holes, and it clicks in and begins to glow.
All right. And I had, I think,
your reflection. Your reflection in the mirror seems to kind of have kind of sunken cheeks.
Great. I mean, I'll place the one that she fessed up to having and gave me.
Okay.
Which there were three others that she did not fess up to having.
Same thing happens.
Put her now in a sock.
It clicks in. You kind of have these deep bags under your eyes now, and your complexion becomes much more pale.
Oh.
All right.
What does that mean?
I'm wondering if we should avoid looking at this mirror while we place these. I don't know if this could have... Is anyone magically inclined worried about this? you can stand to the side and place an eyeball without directly looking into the mirror.
Yeah, GH88, you're like taking a bit of rust. Or 98.
Can anyone tell if there's magic on it?
It's kind of obvious that there's magic on it. Well,
can anyone check?
Like what? I don't feel any difference.
Is it worth checking to see if this is a trap that's possibly going to activate and do something to us similar to what we're seeing?
We'll think too much, pretty lady. Let's just get these things in and go. Get it in. And let's go.
Who had the other one? The ones that we got from the rooms with the.
I thought you were ladies. Holding them.
Did you give them to me? You took them from the illusion.
Check your bags. Who has the eyeballs?
I'll put.
Yeah, I think I grabbed those two from the.
Yeah.
Just check your bags. Who has the eyeballs?
We all check our bags.
You all check your bags.
Yeah.
Okay.
I know I didn't have any eyeballs.
And that. While you do find a couple okay. more eyeballs than you thought you had, you do account for the remaining six. Okay, so one by one, you click the remaining eyeballs into the spaces around the mirror. And as you do, your reflection in the mirror starts to grow even more sickly. You start to lose hair, and your teeth start to fall out. As you're putting in the last couple of eyeballs, even chunks of flesh start falling off. And you stare, and as you're putting in the last eyeball, you are staring at the reflection of you at a party of undead and one rust bucket. Two rust buckets.
Remember, I thought I heard skeletons through this door the last time we were here. So,
and as you click the last eyeball into place, the vault door then starts to grind upward. And inside, you find a domed candlelit room 50 feet high. The polished marble floor is so perfectly reflective that it creates the illusion of standing at the entrance to a sphere. 9 alcoves filled with glittering treasure open up along the walls. In the middle of the chamber, a large spherical object hovers under a black silk drape 20 feet above the floor.
I'm assuming that's the nipple.
That's the nipple.
Whoa. We drew this out on our map, and it looks like a booby.
This might be a room to check for magic and traps before we start touching things.
At the far
too late, I'm already touching.
As you're taking in the room, you hear the rattling of bones at the far end of the room, and you find yourself, and you see at the far end a skeleton kind of walking slowly, pacing around with a head that has this weird cubic shape.
Another
square
one of those.
Shape coming out.
One of those weird things.
I forget. Did we?
No.
We,
this would be. No, you've got.
We've got two.
And the square. This would be a pentagon.
Kalana got the square because she took out the thing in the wine room.
This would be a pentagon.
So, and you would have the triangle because you took it from Tavriel's body.
The thing coming out the top. Yep.
I feel like this might be a conspiracy if the Pentagon is involved.
How far across the room?
It's all the way across to the far side.
I mean, how many feet is that?
That'd be 50 feet.
50.
Okay, I can probably cantrip that. She's going to go to my spells because I can't click
is it
the right
like moving around or is it just like
it's just kind of standing there, kind of shuffling a little, kind of pacing right. there.
Lana says, oh, before it can run away and raises a hand and purple radiant energy descends on that skeleton. Sacred flame.
Sacred flame.
Yep.
Purple radiant.
So make the skeleton has to make a dexterity 15 save.
It gets 6.
Fail.
Okay, roll damage.
That's going to be 11 radiant damage.
Okay, it kind of... Let's see. It doesn't do extra versus undead, does it?
No. No, okay. That would be him and his smiting shenanigans. I'm not a paladin, so... Yeah.
Okay. The skeleton starts, and then starts to run up the wall.
Whoa. Quick, the someone else to run up the wall. Take it down.
Ready, take a shot. All right, are we in initiative?
We are not quite in initiative yet.
Hot shots. If you don't take it down, she's going to launch another cantrip.
Yeah, so it's moving up. It's moving up. It's still around 50 feet away from you.
Twenty-nine.
You hit. Roll damage.
Try that. That's pretty good.
13.
13 damage. Okay, your shot hits it, and skeleton crumbles, and it kind of rain of bone falls down in the back of the room, with the and the head, bloop, just kind of sits there on top of the pile.
All right. We should scoop that up, but we should also check for other magic things and. Traps before we go much further.
I'm going to use my eye screen with the lasers that shoot out and detect traps.
Detect traps.
Or find traps.
I believe find it's traps.
The spell, yeah.
How does it define trap again?
Can we have pH there? Clear
something. Here we are.
So we now have a triangle, a rectangle, and a cube. Am I writing that down correctly? Or was this spherical?
A triangle, a cube, and a five-sided one. Pentagonal.
Okay.
You sense the presence of any trap within range that is within line of sight, which is 120 feet. A trap for the purpose of this spell includes anything that would inflict a sudden or unexpected effect you consider harmful or undesirable, which was specifically intended as such by its creator. Thus, the spell would sense an area affected by the alarm spell, glyph of warding, mechanical pit trap, but it would not reveal a natural weakness in the floor or unstable ceiling or a hidden sinkhole. The spell merely reveals that a trap is present.
Is present.
You don't learn the location of each trap, but you do learn the general nature of the danger posed by a trap that you sense.
You do sense a trap, and it seems to be a captive type kind.
Okay. DH98 scans the room and says, there is some sort of a trap that involves capturing an individual, I believe. I cannot pinpoint exactly its location.
I wonder if perhaps...
Can you detect if it's magical or not?
I don't know if it specifically says...
You'd have to cast detect magic.
Detect magic.
Right. Give me a few minutes.
Ritual cast.
Start the ritual for...
Okay. You're all still standing outside the room in that hallway, right?
Yeah, we're still standing outside.
Yeah, I mean, a couple of us are kind of... How wide was the door? Is it like a 10
It's a 5 foot wide.
It was a 5 foot. It's okay, 5 foot so wide. We each took turns in the doorway shooting the skeleton down.
Yeah.
5 feet.
Okay. He was here shooting.
Oh, yeah, that would be...
I was...
here scanning.
Probably not the best.
5 foot hallway or 10 feet?
It's a 5 foot hallway. Okay.
It's actually 15 feet back to the turn that goes that way.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Meet shield bringing up the rear, or...
That's Durkus.
Durkus. Nice.
I mean, people can arrange themselves.
Durkus is totally putting her sword up your butt.
Whoa.
I don't have my phone to take a picture. Sorry.
Are you ritual casting, Brian?
Yes. Start the ritual to cast detect magic.
Okay. Okay. You cast your detect magic, and you cast your eyes about the room from the doorway. Your range is only 30 feet on that, correct?
Correct. 30-foot sphere.
Okay. Which is, as far as your detection can go, it just gets to that strange floating orb in the middle covered in a drape. And you get illusion magic from that.
Hmm. So would I deduce that it's not really there? Or it's just...
No, you can deduce whatever you like.
But it's illusionary magic.
You detect illusion magic, an aura of illusion magic coming from that draped sphere.
I'm sorry, did you say there were any doors or anything in this room?
Not that you can see from where you are. There are alcoves around the edges that hold the treasures, but you do not see any other doors.
Okay, so there are alcoves with treasures.
I heard things shooting up there. Are there things to fight? I'm ready to fight. I'm feeling very ready to fight right now. Very rested and ready.
We found another one of those skeletons with the weird stuff sticking out
Great,
of its skull.
Great, let's go. Let's fight.
Well, it's already taken care of.
Why do you not call the regress?
Well, we wanted to check the room first, so we took care of it at range. So what did you
so
find?
So cautious.
Well, that the floating orb thing is magical.
He says that the floating...
It's got some illusion magic on it.
Floating orb is illusion, and then he said that it looks like there's some kind of trap magic that would keep something contained or trapped within that room. He doesn't know exactly where, just so you're aware. I mean, if we want to go in and check it out, I'm fine, but those are the things that we know.
Well, we're not doing anything, just standing in this hallway feeling cramped. Okay. I can't even see anything.
Well, I enter the room.
You enter the room.
I enter the room.
Okay. Make a dexterity saving throw.
Oh, crap.
Crap.
That's not bad. 19.
Okay. As you step into the room, you find that the floor is polished so smooth, it's actually slick. But you manage to keep your feet.
Oh.
Oh, boy.
So did we see A kind of like slip a little bit and then catch himself?
Oh, yeah.
Careful of his floor hands. Very slippery.
It's like a nice skating rink.
What's that?
Oh. Clearly you guys do not
so you shoulder
enjoy
your way
winter
past
sports
everybody
like
kobolds.
Or goblins.
Dirty saving throw.
Sports.
Kobold everything sport.
dexterity... So that is going to be 19.
Okay. You are heeding his warning. You are prepared for it, and you also keep your feet.
Yes. All right. I'm gonna try to move past Mayok and kind of hug the wall.
Okay. Same throw.
plus three, Greg?
Yes.
Plus three. Nice. 18.
No problem. Your gyros keep you upright.
He's gyrating.
All right, who else is coming?
I'm going to walk half speed, cautiously, like penguin walk into the room. See.
All right. Since you're walking half speed, make the check with advantage.
Okay.
Or the saving throw, I should say.
Close to me, Sam, at least. She's so funny.
That is our daughter.
She's a character.
She's very talky.
Wow, that's not great. That's a 7. That's a 2. Okay, that's 4. That's 11. Plus 3.
It's plus 3.
Yeah, 14.
14. You kind of slide a little bit, but you still manage to keep your feet.
All right.
Darkest.
I'm going to go in there and make sure that I use a little bit extra of my clawy claws in my toey beans.
Okay. You get the wall walkies and the wall stickies and everything right now, too.
That's true.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's, I mean, the claws don't really let you get a purchase on the floor, but they do let you get a bit of extra grip, so advantage.
Okay. My little toe beans. Is this a
dexterity saving?
Dex. Okay, so that's 19. You're without fine. His help.
You're fine.
Yeah.
Okay. That leaves. Okay, so
Gears.
Upper dog.
That leaves Gears. Gonna let Gears in.
Yeah.
Gears right. Point one.
I'm Gears. Yeah. Use my right. Knights of Roleplay D20. 13.
13. Okay. Gears and servos also keep it nicely balanced. All right. As everyone enters the room, suddenly you hear a low, deep.
Oh no, Skeletor is
and
here.
And a deep, loud, booming voice echoes across the chamber in this language that is both very unsettling to hear and very rolling. It goes on for just a minute.
Does it actually say anything?
It does say something.
Just give it a hard time.
And as it's speaking, the skeleton head lifts up from the pile of bones, kind of floats for a moment over in front of the sphere, and then just seems to vanish.
In front of the curtain?
In front of the curtained orb, yes.
Whatever that is under there?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Let's see. Who has... Let's see. Did we get back to... Losing my place. Okay. Let's see. Cabazon. Does anybody have Cabazon? That's what you have, right, Greg?
Greg, do you have Cabazon?
Yes, he does.
Yes. Yes.
Thank God.
You hear a whispering in your mind from Cabazon. He says, "There's probably something underneath that drape. Attack it quickly before it can, before it attacks us."
Okay.
Okay.
Talking is over.
Wait. Did you not hear what he said?
Roll initiative. He's attacking.
All right.
What did he say?
He said roll initiative.
Oh, did we even understand what he said, or it was like
nobody understood what he said?
Okay, because I speak Infernal.
So that you know of.
Probably Abyssal or something.
That you know of.
It's deep speech.
It's the last game.
Do you know if any of your players know deep speech?
Yeah.
I don't.
Okay.
That was a terrible initiative.
That's okay. Go ahead, Mayock. What you got?
Six.
Six.
What's your dexterity?
I didn't roll my advantage.
AA also got you got a seven.
Seven.
It's plus zero.
Juana.
Well, that's not great. Not at all. Nine.
Nine. Dirkus?
30-20.
30-20. Okay.
GH98? But he's pretty sure you're fucked.
16.
Okay. Well, Dirkris, run the initiative, so if you have something to say or do, now's the time to do it.
Oh, God, how do I summarize this quickly? That guy talked to me. I don't know why you didn't understand him. He's Belchork. The unseen, and he had to deal with that skeleton you killed. He says we're never gonna get past the door. Now attack! Is it skeleton still here? The guy that laughed?
You didn't see the source of the laughter.
Oh, okay.
The source of the voice.
The source of the voice.
Yep.
Okay. what are we attacking?
He's running towards the thing at the center of the room. If you can see it. He's the one.
Can I attempt to grapple him to stop him?
I'm really strong. It's not going to work.
I'm really strong, too.
It's a challenge check. She could still beat you, even as strong as you are. You roll poop,
she'll
win.
Would you consider this a fall into the no PvP rule?
Stein trying to stop a fellow...
I don't think Sarah's character... Tell me if I'm wrong, but you're not attacking him. You're not trying to harm
him. No, I'm just
trying
to grapple him to stop him from attacking
the
thing in the middle.
Okay, well, that is still an attack roll to attempt the grapple.
It's an attack.
I thought it was a challenge check.
It is.
It's a challenge. Yeah.
That's right. It's an oppose.
It's opposed
it's
check.
Strength versus his strength or acrobatics.
Correct.
Right. I am great with
athletics
the rules here.
Versus Greg's athletics or
acrobatics.
Athletics.
Oh, that's right. He uses up your attack action. That's what's great.
Correct.
To make a special melee attack. Okay.
And why are you trying to stop him again?
Because I don't think it's a good idea to go after the orb. Yet. Because clearly I'm the only one that heard, like, understood what that voice was saying.
Yeah. That's what I was like.
And Dorcas may be stupid, but when Dorcas is the stupid one and is the only one that heard what the big scary voice said, we should take a minute.
Make a strength athletics. You can counter with either strength athletics or dexterity acrobatics. I'm assuming you're going to do strength athletics.
Yes.
Be bold to do dexterity.
You're only like two or maybe three above me in your modifier. So, fuck.
You both rolled really low.
Well, it's a fifth. It's actually
15.
15.
Dead heat.
So if meets beats, how does that apply in this case?
With opposed checks, usually when there are a lot of situations where when the numbers are the same, the situation doesn't change. When there's an opposed check, that's what happens a lot. Like if someone's trying to hold the door and they're trying to push the door open, and they both roll 15, then nothing changes.
Unchanged is you miss the grapple.
So I just like grab his leg and dragging me along.
I like that.
Not quite. It's more.
He's still moving towards it. You kind of bounce off of him, and
it's more.
You grab his arm and he shrugs you off.
Try to wrap your little arms around him, but you just kind of manage to shrug her off without even really thinking about it as you continue your charge. All right.
Rage.
GH98.
No, I didn't attack anything.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's me.
Yeah.
Yep.
And I didn't hear anything about attacking the sphere, right?
You just know he's charging towards the sphere.
She told all of us that the voice said that it was something that starts with B, and that the skeleton was
his friend. And that we should therefore attack, were your words.
That's what Dirk said?
Yes.
No.
Did I say that? I can't remember.
You did at the end say, so...
We need to kill something.
We need to attack.
I'm going to use Sacred Flamethrower. There's no creature there right now, right?
What are you using it on? That's right. It requires a creature target?
It does. I can't.
You don't see a creature.
I can't target an object.
Can I read them what he actually said? Because it was on a turn. I didn't know how much I can actually say.
Yeah, I mean, technically it was more than...
It was already more than... It's fine.
A lot of things happened simultaneously.
Yeah, I don't think Dirkris would have been able to, like, word for word say it back anyways.
I know.
Dirkris.
there's no enemy right now that I can see, right?
Not that you can see.
But Mayak is running across there to the curtain.
Mm-hmm.
Dirkris tried to stop Mayak. Dirkris said something about attacking the curtain, right, or something?
She just said we need to attack. She didn't say
we need to attack. Gotcha.
He said you think you can ruin the deal that he struck with the... Or that he... wrung from the rotting corpse of a wizard. You'll never get past the door now.
I'm going to... ready to use Sacred Flamethrower when I see an enemy.
Okay.
So Durkris...
That's it. I take the ready act.
Okay.
So Durkris, 98.
All right. So I'm going to go back to...
I cast Speak with Dead. What did he know?
those of you who are magically sensitive suddenly find that you are not.
Say what now?
Feel cut off from our magic.
Yep. Your ready spell fizzles in your hand.
Okay, so I try to ready the spell. Mm-hmm. And I'm not really able to.
Well, you ready it on your turn, but then it suddenly fizzles in your hand.
Okay, gotcha.
As if it just suddenly just got cut off.
Okay, understood.
Yep. And the drape on the sphere gets yanked aside, and let's see. At that moment, Mayok, GH98, you are suddenly pulled off of your feet and slam into that orb in the middle of the room. Now, and you, which is 20 feet off the ground, and you are stuck there.
Oh, jeez.
So the curtain disappears.
Well, it gets pulled off.
It gets pulled off.
Mm-hmm.
By unforeseen forces.
Just kind of on its own.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then there's a sphere. What does the sphere look like? Is it like
it is a
metallic or?
Yeah, it is a black. Let's see. How is this? Yeah, it's a black dark iron sphere.
Okay. And the two of us get.
And the two of you are now stuck to it.
Okay.
Mayok. It feels like it's your armor that's stuck to it.
Okay.
As well as your metal weapon is also stuck to it.
Okay, so it's a magnet.
Anybody who has a metal weapon is going. Anyway.
Oh boy.
And that was action.
How do you deal with that?
Okay. Let's see. And back to combat. Okay. So, Kalana, you are up.
Okay.
What is your weapon?
She had probably her rapier out.
If it's metal, make a, let's see. Okay, no, as long as you're holding onto it. Okay. You feel the tug of that sphere on your weapon, but you are able to hold onto it.
Okay.
Give me an actual perception check.
Okay.
Did we take damage from being pulled?
You did not, but you are both stuck and
our speed is zero.
And let's see. You are restrained.
Okay, so I have to add my condition restrained.
All right. 24.
Which means your speed is zero, your attack, any attacks you have disadvantage, and you have disadvantage on dexterity saving throws.
Perception check 24.
Okay. From the... You hear that deep laugh again, and this time you can kind of tell it's coming from something up towards the ceiling in the middle of the room, but you can't see it. But you kind of have an idea of where it is.
I believe I found the trap. Has to go sliding across the room.
Make a dexterity saving throw.
What, me?
Yes. Okay. Start of your turn.
All right, that's a good time.
I said there's a lot of things I have to keep track of here.
It'll be, yes.
20.
Yeah.
That's a good roll.
That'll be 24. Is he still within 10? 24.
Okay, fine. You keep your feet.
I'm glad I'm stuck right next to the paladin.
There is that.
So we have to do stuff.
So I'm going to tell the party, I think the source of the laughter that we need to attack with the magic is up there. And okay. I'm going to point to the spot.
Okay.
Communicate first. And then, do I feel cut off from my telekinesis?
You feel cut off from all magic.
All magic, okay.
In fact, any magical items you have are currently not working as well.
That's a good time.
Or at least not magically.
Well, you can still hit something with it, but it isn't, yeah.
Well, meaning could you use it? It just doesn't have the plus one, or...
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay.
So in teleportation, no worky. Racial feature stuff, even if it's
those
magical
are non-magical.
Based. Oh, racial feature is non-magical?
Typically it is, unless it's magic.
And unless it specifically says
it
is magic.
She can teleport as a racial feature once per long rest.
But, that's a gray area.
Well, I mean, Dirkris has a racial feature to be able to walk on walls, right?
Yeah. So okay. Yeah, that's fair.
That's not magical.
That's fair.
But okay. if you're like an Eladrin elf or something and you get Mage Hand, it's like, yes, that's magical. Yeah.
Okay. So teleportation is okay, or
as long as it's a racial feat, yes.
Okay.
And not like a magic thing that you get for being that race.
Yeah. Yeah. You don't. If the racial feat gives you the spell to teleport, that won't work.
Okay.
If it's a racial feat to teleport, that will work.
Okay.
If it says that you get Misty Step, then that won't work.
Right. No, it's
if it says you can teleport, and that's all it says.
Sorry, I don't know
John
if I'm going to use it
teleport.
This turn, but I just want to clarify the understanding of it. Blessing of the Raving Queen. Once per long rest is a bonus action, you can teleport up to 30 feet to an unoccupied space you can see. You also gain resistance to all damage when you teleport until the start of your next turn.
Okay, yeah, so that's a deity-granted power, so yeah, you can use that.
That's not a spell, it's a divine blessing.
Yeah.
Right. So the question is, do I get the sense if I keep my footing that I could move without, like, slipping out immediately again, or does it feel so unstable that if I even try to take, like, one step, I'm probably going to fall over again?
You think you can move as long as you can keep your feet.
Okay. She is going to try to skirt the room first for her normal movement. She's just kind of assessing. So
okay.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30.
Okay.
Okay.
So you move out there?
Yes.
Okay. As you move out there, you suddenly feel your magic coming back to you. Come back to you.
Interesting.
Are you ruling, John, that this, from this point forward, that this effect of the magic being gone, like, you know when it's there and you know when it's not? Based on what you just did with her?
Like, you can feel it?
Those who are magically attuned could tell.
Okay.
You know if you've got the magic in you.
Yeah.
It's an important distinction before I start wasting my spell slots to see if the magic is still there.
You did. I forgot. I a lot of things to keep track of. I forgot to clarify. When you got pulled to the sphere, you felt your magic come back.
Okay, cool. Okay. That's good to know.
So
it's back now.
So far, the dead zone.
Where we are.
In front. So I'm going to look at them. I'm either going to do something fun and magical. Sorry, this is a lot to grapple with you. I'm just trying to figure out.
It's a weird fight.
A good action, but, yeah. And I'm tired. But I'm the tired.
You just had a long rest.
Kate
is the tired. So she is going to take advantage of something that doesn't take concentration, just in case she gets hit by that field again. She's going to conjure a spiritual weapon.
Okay.
Its range is 60 feet. She can put it off the floor. You said that I had a spot where I perceptified something that was probably invisible. So I'm going
to
try...
Up to 50 feet up on the ceiling.
Sure. Mm-hmm. A spiritual weapon has a range of 60 feet. So I'm going to conjure it roughly behind the area where I thought something was up on the ceiling.
Okay. When you say behind, just kind of point...
Like, generally, if I thought it was up there on the ceiling, about there, I'm going to put it, right behind it.
So... Okay, so opposite
the general
door.
Area of
opposite the door. She's analyzing. So
you cast your spiritual weapon and it does appear there.
Okay, I'm gonna hit it.
Okay, make an attack roll with disadvantage.
Okay, because it is invisible.
It's invisible.
Yeah.
Invisible.
Hang on, let me burn my spell slot to cast this. Second level. Do I have that?
Clash of Bands.
Attack. Do I have a spiritual weapon on there? I do. Okay.
Just make a really
seven. Cool
cosplay. Okay. Just saying.
Alright. I believe you. D8. Woo! AC 12 to hit.
AC 12. Okay. It swings at nothing, and it hits nothing.
Okay. All right. Well, you guys can see her purple floaty thing up there swinging at nothing.
That we know of.
Yeah. And then I still have my action clear, because that was bonus action. I got a question for you. Mm-hmm. Based on her recollection of... who was before A.A.?
You don't even remember his name.
Yeah, I'm really tired. really. I'm not reading.
You are before AA.
Our previous goblin companion.
Oh.
Fang and or Hergroth. I don't remember who it was who had analyzed the eyeballs on the slime and said that they were beholder eyes.
Okay.
What kind of check would you want me to make to... see if I can identify some of the phenomenon that we're encountering in this room associated with the creature.
This round, none. You've already taken your action.
I didn't take an action. That was a bonus action.
Oh, that was your bonus action.
Yeah.
Make an arcana check.
Okay. Is my arcana worth poop? We'll find out. Not great. We'll find out. Okay. Which one? Who wants to play nice this time?
Nobody.
Here's the ninth of roleplay die.
That's not terrible.
Let's see. Doesn't roll well for the two of us. Although mine's been rolling better.
Yeah, so it's 14.
14. You don't have enough to work to go on to have picked up anything.
Okay. All right. So that was my action then to make that check.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm just gonna say attack up there and hold where I am. Mm-hmm. I mean, you guys saw me cast a spell, so hopefully magic people might observe that.
Okay, at the end of your turn, let's see. a sickly green ray shoots out from the location that you're looking at and shoots towards you.
Towards who?
Towards Kalana.
Oh, boy.
Make a dexterity saving throw.
Oh, no.
That's not a good
ray.
Kate, I've never seen a player that's been shot at with a green ray more than you.
I'm debating if Kalana saw the green ray that hit Tabriel and if she's going to burn her inspiration to roll the save with advantage just out of hand, although she's got a fair amount of hit points right now.
Kalana was nowhere near when Tabriel died.
Well, Kalana was in a cage in the room with the door open, so she saw it from a distance. Let's see here.
That's okay. Inspiration's kind of a metagame thing anyway.
Yeah. Yeah. We're just going to go for it. All right. And I'm not close enough to you to get the perk, so whatever. All right. Dexterity saving throw?
Dexterity saving throw.
Times. All right. Oh. Okay. Dexterity saving throw is 24, because the dice apparently likes rolling a save for that.
Awesome.
Okay. You do manage to dodge out of the way of the ray.
Okay.
Okay. AA, you're up. You have a pretty good idea of where it's coming from where it is, from where that ray just suddenly originated from.
So they says if it's a creature, if it's just a magical creature.
It's talking to you and it's attacking you, so you have a pretty good idea that it's a creature.
All right. I feel that all my magic is gone, correct? From where I'm standing.
You're standing, yeah.
You do not feel any connection to the weave
you
or whatever you
want to
call it.
You don't feel the magic in you right
now. I guess this world has the weave, so yeah.
Did you,
you don't got the magic in you.
Did you relay to the party when you moved that your magic came back?
You saw me cast the spell.
That's true.
She's, yeah.
So I go next to, Kalana.
Okay, make your dexterity saving throw.
With my knights of roleplay.
Hopefully we don't have to make it, Greg, because we're stuck to a sphere.
You have no dexterity, you're stuck.
Eight.
You get startled by the ray, and your feet slip out from under you, and you fall prone. You can still stand up for half your move, but...
Yeah, I'll do that and try to move again.
Okay, what's your move?
30.
30, so you can move 15 feet closer to where Kwan is. And... Okay, yep, as you step over there, you do feel your magic come back.
All right, here we go. All
right, I point at the creature on the ceiling.
Invisible spot.
Okay.
And I cast Hex on it.
Do you need to be able to see your target to cast Hex?
Probably.
If it says a target, if it requires a target that you can see, then you cannot target it.
Let's see.
This is the fight for area.
You can see within range. All right. So no. All right.
You don't have to spell magic. Yeah. I think that's your flavor.
Right, okay, here we go. I'm going to use the bonus action to cast Branding Smite. This is the next time I hit a creature with a weapon attack before the spell ends. The weapon gleams with astral radiance as you strike.
Okay.
The attack deals an extra
2d6.
Gotcha. That was the bonus action. Nice.
So now I do my attacks.
My attack now is... Pew pews.
With disadvantage.
Magic pew pews.
Disadvantage.
Because I can't see it.
Because you can't see it. Because you can't see your target. Yep.
Great.
Because invisibility is a thing.
You need a disadvantage either.
So they're attacking something that's like up here?
Correct.
Got a purple spiritual weapon hanging up there, arrows flying up.
So it's still, it came down from like the very top of the ceiling?
No, it's still hanging up there.
No, like the beam came down from the very top of the ceiling?
The beam came from something up there.
Define your pronouns.
Love you a long time.
My pronouns are the, she, and it. Okay. I am the shit.
15.
You hit the ceiling behind it.
Great. Fire again.
Fire again.
18 or 19? It's got to go with the 18. So 18 plus 12, 30.
30. Okay. Your shot seems to hit something. Roll damage.
So you do a smitey smite. 2d6. Oh, yes. That sounds right.
Oh, the branding smite does go off on this one, yes, because it's the first time you hit.
2d6. So.
Whoops.
Sarah is crawling under the table looking for a die.
How much?
14 magical piercing, 4 radiant.
Okay.
That's kind of a bummer.
What kind of dice was it?
There's a better
dice. What color?
I don't know.
Okay.
Oh, I see it.
14 magical piercing
under the table bar.
Yeah.
Watch ahead. Bonk.
Okay.
What was that noise on the recording? Oh,
you hear another laugh and some more weird guttural words.
You need to play some like recordings in reverse and then add that to the
I am going to action surge.
Nice.
Okay, one action splurge later.
Shoot him again.
Do I even want to know?
I know what it's saying.
Oh, is that why he's texting you?
Yeah. Thank you, Discord.
18 to hit.
You again managed to land a hit on something up there.
10 magical piercing.
Okay.
Pew pew. Guess who's making himself a target?
And then. Attacking again.
I might have to send these to Chris so that he can post them with the podcast.
19 to hit.
19 also hits.
Another 10 magical piercing.
The translations.
Okay. You good?
You could read them out loud too. We just all know on our side have to not meta with them.
Yeah, that's my.
That's why he's sending them to me. Because he knows how you guys are. Kate.
Okay, Maya, you are.
You know that I can detach myself.
I know you can. I just like to give you a part.
Yeah.
Dispel magic.
Dispel magic. Okay. In this particular case.
Is that
going to
drop you 20 feet?
Well, he's trying to cast it up the ceiling.
So you cast it up at... Let's see. Hang on 1 second.
The thing that all the beams is coming from.
One creature, object, or magical effect that can reach any spell third or lower on the target happens. For each... Okay. Okay, then you need to... make an ability check using your spell casting ability, which is your charisma? Yes.
Yes.
So, yeah. So, make a charisma check.
That's actually...
Come on, big money. Come on, big money.
Charisma.
Plus your charisma modifier.
Oh, okay.
That's like your whatever your casting ability modifier is. If you go to
plus
your spells.
Plus 3, so it's 18.
18. Okay. You cast it up at the ceiling... But nothing seems to happen.
Darn it all.
Thing is running invisibility at high level.
Well, I thought I had to tell you what level the spell was.
Huh?
that he
well,
could...
Well, the rule at the beginning was that we did say that you would say,
yeah,
I'm casting Dispel Magic at level blah.
And if you don't say, it's default level, which is third level.
Well, that's all I could have casted at anyways.
So. Yeah.
I thought you had a fourth level slot. Okay. Spacey.
Okay. That's your action. Anything else? I mean, you don't have to make the dexterity saving throw.
Right. Because
you're stuck.
Because you're stuck. But round two, Durkris. Oh, hang on. Sorry. At the end of that round.
No, you said it was round two.
No, you haven't said anything yet, so. Yeah. AA. You find a, what color would that be? How about a, kind of a yellow ray? Suddenly shoots out from that area, towards you. Make a constitution saving throw.
This is the urine effect.
Yes.
The dog is going to pee on the
floor.
Pee-pee
on you.
The urine.
Maybe it will make it less slippery. We'll cut down on some of the wax. Have an inspiration?
No, I do not. So that's going to be eight.
Eight. Okay, that beam hits you square on the chest. And you suddenly find you can't move. You are paralyzed.
Oh, no. Including his pee-pee?
You had to
urine?
Ask.
I mean, his urine pee-pee.
Toddler in the house. We can talk about these things.
Okay. Okay. So, round two. Fight, Durkris. You are up. Metaphorically speaking.
Do the walls of this Thunderdome look like they're climbable?
You think you could probably climb the Thunderdome?
Suction feet.
I'm going to attempt to climb up the wall towards the source of this power beam that just zapped my new doggy friend.
What is your movement?
My movement.
Your speeds?
As a tiny kobold, my movement is 40.
Is 40. With a 25-foot radius, you shouldn't have any trouble getting up to the top of the dome.
Okay. As I am working my way up to the top of the dome, I am going to...
Oh, hang on. But before you start moving, make your dexterity saving throw.
Do my claws give me anything?
Advantage.
Advantage.
Because you do have that climbing speed, so I'll allow that.
Ooh,
you're
nice.
Fine.
Nice.
Yeah, that's a 21.
Yeah, whatever, you're fine.
Okay,
I will rage.
Roar with my rage.
She's raging.
I'm raging because I am so happy I can finally go. And with that rage, What is going to engorge? I haven't engorged in a long time. We will go raging form of engorged tail.
Engorged tail.
And with rage, I will run up and still strike with my warhammer.
Oh. Okay, make an attack roll with disadvantage, unless you're recklessly attacking or something like that.
What are you attacking?
I'm attacking the invisible thing that's been shooting people. With her spectral weapon, that's not considered an ally within 5 feet, right?
No.
Okay. I ran up to the ceiling. I will recklessly attack.
Okay, attack normal.
Do it.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, shit.
Dome ball, the mini's over.
Oh.
That was a really bad attack. I rolled a 5 and a 7.
You could modify.
That would be a 15.
You get a little bit too overexcited, and you swing and a miss.
Oh, my tail got me too excited.
Sarah, you rolled 2 dice.
She went reckless. I went reckless.
You're rolling normal.
Oh.
Because you're rolling with disadvantage.
Because you're still rolling with disadvantage. Cancels.
Well, either way, it missed.
It still missed. It missed worse.
But. So the second one's going to be at disadvantage, right?
No, it's a normal.
Still normal?
It's still normal, yeah.
Are all your attacks with advantage when you attack wrestlers?
Yes, they're all.
Then because of the disadvantage, they cancel each other out, so you attack
single
normal.
Single dice.
Okay.
All right, straight up attack roll. Here we go.
All right. No whammies. Yay! 26.
26. Oh, you connect with something.
Oh, yay! Connected! All right, let's roll that damage. That's a 4 plus 4 is 8 plus my rage, which is 3. So, 11.
11.
11 bludgeoning damage.
11. Okay, you feel a solid connection. And hear a tiny grunt. Followed by some more weirdly sounding words.
So, Sarah, can you put yourself on there in the space that you would
you
be if you were on the ceiling?
Flying thing?
Flying stand.
Something down there.
Okay, we have one high-flying kobold on the map.
Well, we're up high, too.
And that would be my turn.
Okay.
You guys are only, like, half that height, though, right?
Yeah. At the end of your turn, you suddenly see...
Oh, no.
Sort of a light and airy colored ray.
Light and airy has a color?
Yes, it does. It has more of a feel than a color.
It's strawberry fields forever.
Well, where's the color when we head out?
Well, anyway, make a wisdom saving throw.
She's so wise.
As this ray gets blasted in your face point blank.
Is she in range of his buff?
No. She's 50
feet.
They're
20
feet
up.
He's 20.
And she's 50.
Oh, that's true.
So she's 30 feet above, yeah. Okay.
Nat 20.
Nat 20.
Nice.
Well, still, what's your modifier?
20. It's a 20.
Okay, so modifier 0.
Yeah.
Okay.
I got no wisdom. Do I look like a wise kobold to you?
It could have been a negative.
It's true.
Okay. Even though the ray hits you in the face and you start to kind of nod off, you kind of shake it off.
Player's gonna play. And the kobold gonna stay.
GH98. You're stuck.
Okay. Let's see.
Stuck on you. That's a good 20.
Now that I put
right
the flying stands there, this is more difficult.
Timely.
Well, we could move them so that you could, you know. Don't get to use the flying stand very often right now. It's kind of fun.
So as far as I can tell, I can use this and not hit anybody.
Yeah, we haven't had to do this.
Yeah, the spiritual weapon is a creature, so it's a non-issue as far as being in an area of effect.
Right. So.
See, I had to make an ode to Tina Turner because we did say we were in the Thunderdome, and I was going to say, all the heroes say, all the people say, we don't need another hero. Mm-hmm.
I did call it the Thunderdome.
You did.
Although one of us is paralyzed, so maybe another hero wouldn't get to the banning.
I mean, he is a dog.
Okay, no, as far as I know, my magic
paralyzed is... the dog. Oh, I thought it was the dog.
Yeah. I didn't think the dog went, actually.
Dog didn't get a chance to.
Didn't really have a attack.
What you cast?
Didn't really do anything.
Okay, so my magic still works, as far as I know, right?
Your magic seems to be working at the moment.
So a bunch of little, flying discs pop off of GH-98, mm-hmm. go flying up to the top of the ceiling, and create a 10-foot radius, 40-foot high cylinder of flame with flame strike, 5th-level flame strike.
Okay.
So anything within that area has to make a dexterity saving throw.
Okay.
Big wheel keep
the
on turning.
The mysterious creature that you don't know as a beholder makes a saving throw and fails miserably.
It was an eye.
Yeah.
I mean, it's pretty obvious that it's a beholder at this point.
10 eyes in the door.
He gets a 5.
10 eye stalks. Yeah. What?
It's shooting out different colored beams.
Yeah.
So 13 fire.
Okay.
Nice.
Ooh, that's some good rolling.
11, 12, 13, and 16 radiant. Yes.
16 radiant.
Oh. And that is turn.
You hear a small snarl.
Me thinks that maybe you're the one that's in trouble, me.
Flame strike, turnover.
Okay. Once again, you hear some weird, deep speech that you can't quite understand. And
let's see.
And suddenly you find 3 beams come shooting out of a space a little farther away. About 15 feet below you. So that would put it about 15 feet above you.
Okay.
What happened?
So
what?
Possibly moved.
More fire beams.
More beams.
Because an invisible creature doesn't provoke opportunity when it moves. So that's why I shouldn't get to swing on it.
What's 15 feet above me? I'm sorry.
15 feet above you and 15 feet below you, a bunch of beams start shooting out.
Hmm.
And below,
from two different locations?
No. Durkus is 30 feet above you.
Oh, gotcha, gotcha.
So it basically...
It moved in between the two of us.
Gotcha. Gotcha, okay. Gotcha.
Let's see,
tell.
The first...
Understood.
Let's see, the first beam is... Okay, no point in targeting you, so target the one that just smacked him. Durkus, let's see. Yeah, I already said it, so make a constitution saving throw.
Me?
Yep.
Sorry. Okay, I can do that.
I think you probably can.
Okay, can you have like a
cookie? Oh, sorry, I'm chewing my lip.
16.
16? Okay.
Your camera fingerprinted?
You once again get hit by that yellow, or another yellow beam hits you, and you start to feel all stiff.
And stiff
and engorged, but you managed to shake it off.
I shake off my boner that time.
Let's see.
That was not the stiff
boner.
I like.
Rage boner.
Rage boner. Hey, at least I'm not like the Pathfinder game where he has to hit himself in the nuts to get his rage.
Another black beam. A black beam shoots out, or a dark and kind of a black and purple, really kind of nasty looking beam, shoots out and targets. Who would you target? You haven't really done anything yet, so who would target you? You tried to get rid of his invisibility, so he'll target you. Make a... Make a dexterity saving throw, but because you're bound, with disadvantage.
Huh. Rockfall.
I mean, at least you get your own buff.
Yeah. Well, that was a fail.
So I gotta give him the number, Gray.
What was it again?
Dexterity saving throw.
So it's gonna be 4.
Oh no!
Are you rolling with disadvantage? They rolled with advantage. I'm like, that's a 10.
Oh, it was with disadvantage.
Gotcha.
Unfortunately.
In which case, a natural 1 is an auto fail. Which I did not.
Yeah.
I thought you were rolling with advantage. My apologies.
I gotta give him the numbers. I'm like, that's a 1.
I didn't think that 1 was.
I'm like, that's
auto.
A 10.
I thought we didn't auto fail saves.
You do auto fail saves.
Oh, okay.
You definitely auto fail saves.
Okay. Oh, no.
Oh, so that's a lot of dice.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
That's a lot of dice that are D10.
Oh, no.
Oh, well.
We love you, man.
Thanks. It's been nice knowing you.
Well, you can't fall. You're stuck to the thing.
Yeah.
Which won't matter if you're dead. See, Mayock's lifeless body hanging
from the
wall.
At least we just
it's not enough to kill you, but you do take 57 necrotic damage.
Ooh.
Oh, I'm bloody.
Oof.
Oh. And a third ray shoots out. Oh, I already used that one.
But the healer is stuck right next to you, Greg.
That's true.
You
got a heal
bot
right. Your buddy's right there.
I'm looking a little crisp.
a little
crispy
pallid.
Paladin.
You're starting to look like the mirror head you're looking on the door.
Yeah.
He's going to have to make a dexterity saving throw.
Ooh.
GH98.
Killbot.
Well, you have
don't
plus
forget
3.
Your buff.
Alright. He's smart enough to know that you're restrained, so you have to make a dexterity saving throw with disadvantage.
I'm gonna use my inspiration.
Okay. Cancel it.
Yep. Dexterity.
Dexterity.
Ooh, that's nice.
Nice. 22.
Okay. You managed to swing your head out to the side just enough to miss the ray.
What color ray came from him?
That one would be, I guess, kind of a reddish color.
Ew.
Oh, a reddish ray threw him off the balcony before. That would have been interesting.
I don't know. I'm making it up as I go along. So don't hold anything I've said before.
Okay.
As
okay.
Oh, okay.
All right.
A reddish ray claimed the life of our friend.
Go ahead, Kalana.
Oh, Kalana is before AA.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Man, I have done terrible at keeping track of my shit. Okay. So.
If only I had a pink mohawk like my character.
Interesting question.
Mm.
That floating sphere. This is the John-like type of question, actually. Does it look like it has enough of a foothold or purchase that I could teleport and stand on top of it?
It's a 6-foot sphere.
Okay.
Made of iron.
6 feet.
Yeah.
That is big.
Mm.
So.
What are you wearing for armor?
I think it's studded leather.
Studded leather.
Yeah.
She are the studs made of metal?
You could, but you might not like the consequences.
Because of the studs? Let me double check that. That's what I got. I think that this. Wish I had dispel magic. I'd try to dispel a stupid sphere. Well, regardless of that, I am going to move my spiritual weapon down and biff the area that the beams just came from.
Okay,
so that's something to do. So, that's my actions for a second. Dice drive away because the tablet came from.
Spiritual weapon swings in and hits.
Right. Yeah. There's my attacks. Okay. Which is only 1d8. Probably not, unfortunately. AC 14 again.
Nope. It swings and hits air. That's your bonus action?
Yeah, that is my bonus action. I'm sorry. I'm trying to figure out
how to get to see this thing.
Greater invisibility is a pain in the catuchus. Let's see here.
Make a concentration check when I hit it with a bunch of damage.
It did. You don't know.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay. that's worth.
There could be a lot of things that are not actually an invisibility spell.
Do I still want to do
metagaming? It? No, it did not make a constitution. It did not make a concentration check.
Okay.
Greater invisibility. I think there's an invisibility that doesn't require it.
And you said it's 15 feet above them?
You can cast without it going away.
That's it's roughly 15 feet above them from where we see
it. It's roughly 15 feet above the sphere and 15 feet below a clingy kobold.
Okay.
Very clingy.
Sarah's giving John a face.
I'm trying to drop on his head.
You wish I was that clingy. She couldn't have, like, jump from the ceiling and, like, beat you with her tail on the way by. If you jump on an invisible creature, do you land on it? Even though it's invisible?
15 feet.
I would assume if you get the right spot, then it'll be there.
Yeah, I guess we'll just do a normal attack. She's going to drop the rapier, grab her crossbow.
Okay, as you drop the rapier, it flies off and sticks to the sphere.
Okay, that's fine.
Doink!
Rather not keep that on my person. All right, so
roll for
crossbow.
If it hits any of your allies when it does.
Half thought of that.
Right next to Mayok's head.
So disadvantage.
Oh, God.
All right.
I would be very pissed.
Yeah, we all would.
Okay, well, let's attack with disadvantage. See if I can roll. This is terrible again.
Yeah.
Oh, that's actually not bad. I'll take that. So, with disadvantage, that is an AC 22 to hit.
You land a hit.
Okay,
hit
that'll
something.
Be nine piercing.
Okay.
All right.
So is it actually sticking out of it?
I think it's just attached to it, right?
But we can see where it is, though, right?
The rapier, yeah. It's probably just sticking to the side of it, right?
Yeah, the rapier is just stuck to the outside of the
sphere. No, I was talking about what she just did.
No, you still can't see it.
When something's invisible, anything that's on it or in it turns invisible,
well,
too.
It's covered with a shroud of some kind, too. It had, like,
Shroud
that was the sphere.
The shroud was over the sphere. The shroud is now just kind of lying on the floor.
Okay. All right.
I was just hoping we would be able to see where it is.
Okay, so try to dispel the sphere and
I use my paintball gun.
Okay.
But again, the paint would then be on the invisible creature, like, to turn it invisible. It doesn't work like the Invisible Man, where when you dress it up, you can see it, unfortunately.
You splatter it. Kevin Bacon.
That's a good one. Unfortunately, in D&D, that doesn't work.
Come on, man.
Okay. Pseudo Jaws music.
I know this because of a different campaign I've been in.
Okay. This is probably not going to work, but it'd be really cool if it does. Dirkris, make a strength saving throw.
Oh, no. Which she has advantage on, because rage!
Do I?
You should, for if sure. You're raging.
Yeah.
On strength checks and strength checks and saving throws.
Rage against the dying.
I hardly
the
ever do strength saving throws, man.
Stuff sticks in my brain. Look.
Yeah. Love you. You're the best rules lawyer there is, aside from maybe your husband.
Honestly, the DM is pretty high end one, too.
Okay, with advantage, that will be a 23.
Okay. You feel suddenly something try to rip you off the ceiling. But you do manage to hold on.
Those toe beans, man.
It's a good thing you got Nag Nag.
Stability tail.
Just saying, good thing you got Nag Nag.
Well, I already had the ability to walk on ceilings. So.
But you had to use your hands. And now you don't.
Hey.
But my strength didn't change.
Setting our sultry hill bot aside, go ahead, AA.
Is there anything I can do while I'm paralyzed?
Good
make
point.
A skill check or anything like that?
You can attempt to save out of it.
Oh, I can save out of it.
At the end of your turn, you can make another constitution saving throw.
Yeah, it's the end of your turn.
Okay. I'm going to use my Knights of Roleplay D20.
Yeah.
Idiot.
All right. Cocked.
Oh, damn it.
It's a 20 right there. I'm try it again. Constitution saving throw?
Constitution saving throw.
20.
Okay.
That's pretty good.
You manage to shake off its effects. With a powerful will, I guess. You know?
Intestinal fortitude.
Intestinal fortitude. Thank you. You manage to power
thank
through
you, English
the,
major.
power through the paralyzation. Good thing too. I was worried that the Knights of Roleplay D20 was only going to work when it was cock.
That's a whole different kind
well,
of
so far, it's only been really successful for the cock at the table.
Yes, Sarah and I have not had.
Sarah's pointing at the dudes.
I have a. Are there any like dim areas or places that I could hide?
The whole area is lit with candles.
Treasure alcoves.
But at the the end of your turn.
I forgot all about it.
Does Gears do anything? Does Gears do anything?
Legendary action number 3.
Well, it's the end of my turn. Gears takes his turn after my turn. So.
But he doesn't have a bonus action to give a command.
Gotcha.
Because he was paralyzed on this turn.
Gotcha.
Because Kate forgot she could do lesser restoration and unparalyze him.
Yeah.
Well, Gears can still move.
Yeah, Gears can still move on his own.
Would he?
Yeah, he could move to protect.
You're going to allow him to move Gears, yeah? Because Gears doesn't need an action to move.
The command to move would take up your bonus action. He can't. Gears would move to defend himself or something along that lines. But without a command, he won't move.
But he's saying that the command to make him move doesn't take the bonus action or the action. That's a free thing.
It says it can move and use its reaction on its own. The only action it takes on its turn is a dodge action unless you command it to take a bonus action on your turn.
So it's being
to command it to take another
the
action.
The only thing that, the commands are for other stuff.
Right.
In other words, it can move autonomously.
Mm. It can move...
That doesn't sound like it requires any resources.
It doesn't require any resources, but it's the end of his turn. Would he be able to tell it? Would it move on its own?
To protect someone? It seems pretty innate to me.
I mean, you're the DM, John. I mean, I feel like the it would go towards its master, but that's
he's what a I mean, he's it's, a faithful it's he's really, a faithful companion.
It's splitting hairs, I suppose. So yeah, you can move.
We would push for the same part if he was Drax.
I would, and as the and I would expect the DM to push back.
Oh, I got to roll dex for him, right?
Yes,
he needs to roll that to see if he falls. Yeah. not that it's going to matter. He's only moving 10 feet. So.
That dice is like, give me the
18.
Carpet.
Yeah, he holds his.
Or no, it's like 20-something.
Okay, so yeah, at the end of your turn, I have that ray. Who am I targeting with that ray? Kalana just hit him. Kalana, make a constitution saving throw.
Oh, good times.
Aren't you glad you hit him?
Woo.
I wish the...
What color is the ray, John?
Yay! I mean, don't.
What color is the
this
ray?
This one is...
Cyan? Puse?
As a condition.
Violet? Electric green.
Electric avenue?
It's electric. Boogie, boogie, boogie. All right. And you said constitution saving throw?
Correct.
Okay. Let's see here. 23.
Oh my.
She's happy now.
I think you're taking half damage.
And that's a lot of dice.
I need two more d8s.
Oh, hold on.
I was honestly shocked I didn't take half damage from the green beam before.
That's a lot of d8s.
Your husband who loves you asked John if you're supposed to take half damage, just saying.
Love you too.
Just because you love her doesn't mean you just as badly want to watch her die. It's safe to say that at the D&D table. Yeah. Sage advice from Jazzy.
Okay, as this ray hits you, you do manage to shrug off most of its effects, but you still take 25 necrotic damage.
Okay, yeesh. I take half of that because I am of the Shadowfell.
You take half necrotic damage?
I do. I'm resistant to necrotic.
Lucky you.
So half of 24, 25?
Half 12. Of 25 is...
25, 12. Thank you, Sarah, because my math brain ain't there tonight.
All right, Mayok, what's your aura up?
All right.
I love math.
So get off your math, let's do some math. I'm going to try to see if I can dispel magic on the thing.
Okay. Go ahead.
The creature
and,
or the
on the sphere?
On the thing? On the sphere. Okay, so you...
Third level?
Yes. That's all I can do is third level. So.
Okay.
Just making sure you announce it, because you're supposed to announce it.
Actually.
Okay, you manage to turn your head just enough to get a look at the sphere, and you hold your hand out to it, and cast Dispel Magic, and the sphere falls to the floor.
Hey.
With you.
Taking you two with it.
There's lots of clanging.
Do
a superhero.
So what's 20 feet of fall damage?
It's
2d6.
Yeah, it's 3d6.
3d6?
2d6.
A d6 for 10 feet.
Above 10. Okay. Lucky you.
Minimum damage.
The two of you mostly managed to land and roll.
Tuck and roll.
You take 2 bludgeoning damage.
Like the sphere. Okay.
The sphere falls to the ground with a crash, and the floor cracks in spider webs.
Oh,
all
like
across
a mirror.
The
okay. Does that make it easier to walk up?
We don't know yet.
I would think it would be difficult terrain.
It is no. You are correct.
Oh.
You find that you
are not shiny anymore.
Yep.
I got it.
You find
it.
You're able to keep your shape. Okay.
Greg with the
and
win.
On, good job, and Greg. On that note, we will continue this fight next session. All right. So let's go ahead and say goodnight to the listeners.
Bye-bye, listeners.
Goodnight.
Bye, listeners. I'm on the ceiling still.
If you enjoyed this podcast, please leave us a review anywhere this podcast can be found. Our social media links, plus additional content, can be found on our website at knightsofroleplay.com. Please tell your friends about Knights of Roleplay, an adventuring podcast, and spread the word through social media. Your help and support are greatly appreciated.